Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Omega. Welcome back to another video. So today I'm really excited to bring you guys my first Warzone video, and I wanted to just kind of talk about all of the good things about this game, because man, I've been enjoying this game so much. I think a little bit too much. I really did not expect to like this game mode as much as I did, but Warzone is a ton of fun. It's not perfect by any means, and that's kind of what I want to talk about in today's video, just some of the things that could be improved upon that could make this battle royale insane. But let's just start right with the positives, and before I get into that, just want to let you guys know that I'm going to be posting a ton of Warzone clips on my Fruit Lab page. If you guys don't know what Fruit Lab is, it's basically kind of like YouTube and Twitch had a little baby. This new social media network that a lot of people are using, I highly suggest you guys go check it out. You can also earn pips that you can get, like gift cards and stuff. It's basically how I do all my giveaways on my channel, so go check that out. Link is the first link down in the description below. But yeah, man, let's start with the positives of Warzone, and I got five here that I want to talk about. Five big ones. First one being the new shop system that was introduced into this game. So Warzone took an interesting approach to Battle Royale, and they added a shop system in which you can use currency that you pick up from players or just that you find throughout the map, and you can actually buy armor, kill streaks, you can buy weapon loadouts that actually basically remove all aspects of RNG in Battle Royale. And let me just talk about that real quick, because these custom loadouts basically just remove the randomness from Battle Royale games. And I think that's what's kind of been holding a lot of Battle Royale games back, is that, you know, when you land and after playing for a little bit, you know, you have your weapon loadout, but it might not be what exactly, you know, the kind of weapon loadout that you want. Well, now in Warzone, when you get enough cash, you can actually buy these loadout drops that your whole team can use that gives you a full custom class of exactly the type of weapon that you want. If you guys, you know, watched any Modern Warfare gameplay, you know how much weapon customization there is for all of these guns. So it makes it super interesting when you have such a variety of different play styles. Like, you'll see in some of these game modes, I have like a thermal silent sniper. In other ones, I have a kind of like a dual HCOG with like a holographic sight for like long and close range. It makes it really fun and really cool, because now I'm actually in control of the play style and not kind of just forced to use the weapons that I find. And I think that's what a lot of people are enjoying right now about Warzone. You know, it removes a lot of the randomness while still having a ton of people in this battle royale. I don't think I mentioned that this has 150 players in it of each game, and there are also rumors that they're doing a 200 player battle royale game mode with squads of four instead of three. But next up, let's talk about respawning in this game. Now, there are two different ways that you can be respawned back into this game. The first one is if you die within the first, I think, 20 minutes of the game, you're sent to the gulag, which is basically this island prison where you can 1v1 someone else in the game for a chance to come back into the game. And if you win that 1v1, obviously you just get placed back right where your teammates are, or if your teammates are dead, it usually places you close to like a shop or some kind of like loadout drop so you can get weapons again. The second way that you can get respawned is if you lose at the gulag, you will have to wait until your teammates buy you back from the shop. And that's kind of one of the issues I'm going to talk about later on in this video. So if you guys want to hear more about that, be sure to stay tuned to when I get to that part. But the shop system is very cool, and the respawn just makes it so much easier to get back into the action, into the game, which is what I love about this kind of battle royale. There's also new missions and bounties that you can do in between fighting to earn more cash and items in the game. And this is something also really interesting, because since this map is so huge and there is a little bit of downtime, you know, after you kill a bunch of people, sometimes you are just running around trying to find people or find loot. There's these missions that you can do that'll actually earn you cash. And these missions range from going to hold down a position, which is kind of like capturing a flag. The other one is finding a bounty target, which is, you basically hunt another player in the game, and you have this yellow little marker where you get cash if you actually eliminate that player. And in the other sense, you can also be the one hunted, and you have to escape from the enemy, and you get cash the same way by doing that. This makes it really interesting, because when you're done killing people, you can do these side missions, and it makes it so that you're not always kind of like on edge looking for people. Like, this map is big enough where there's a ton of stuff to do, and you can either, you know, choose to go for kills or choose to earn some money for your team. Lots of different things that you can do in this game. I also want to talk about the inventory, because I think the one big problem I had with Blackout was just how wonky the inventory system was and how much items there were to keep track of. And I'm sure the people who played Blackout are going to disagree. I mean, that's just personally my opinion. But what I love about this game is that there are no attachments that you have to worry about. All of the weapons that you pick up in this game are variants, so they're basically just tiers of weapons that as the tier goes up, it goes from, like, I think common to green, which is like, I don't even know what it is. It's like rares. It's something like that. But as the tiers go up, the weapons get better attachments. So you really don't have to worry about attachments whatsoever because you already have your custom classes from the variant if you choose to do it that way. Or you can just pick up these weapons that the game provides in Warzone that have these tiers and these cool attachments already on them. And all of them are basically very useful for Warzone. So even if you don't want to do like one of these weapon variants or one of the care package variants, you can easily just go for one of the guns that you can get in game. And a lot of them are very good. And then finally, this is the last major pro before we get into the negatives of this game, and that is the fact that it is very easy to travel across the map. I'm sure one of the biggest concerns of people before playing this game is seeing how huge this map is and worrying if they're just going to be kind of running around all day. But there are enough vehicles and ways to get around in this map that make it super easy to go across map. I mean, there's helicopters everywhere. The vehicles are very easy to drive. Even the ATVs have a flawless driving system where it just feels way too easy. And you guys saw a clip before where I was basically just perched onto that guy's ATV. I wasn't even actually in it, but I was still able to kind of just like sit on top of it while he was driving me around. So the vehicles are very useful, especially helicopters, man. If you have a helicopter, like, don't be intimidated by flying those. They are super easy. Flying a helicopter is literally just going up and down. Like, there's two buttons basically that you use. You either go up or you go down. So try out the helicopters. They will help you out so much. Definitely do not be intimidated by them. And also the fact that you have unlimited parachutes. So if you ever just want to jump out of a helicopter, you can just pull out your parachute and fly to a different part of the map. And that works the same way if you want to jump off a building or do anything like that. I mean, you got parachutes, so you have such an easy way to fly across the map. All right, so now let's talk about the negatives. And there weren't really a lot of negatives that I had. And maybe it's just because I'm biased and I'm really enjoying this game. But after thinking about it, the one big negative thing that I think a lot of other people agree with me is the solo experience. The solo experience in this game, like a lot of other team-oriented battle royales, is very lackluster. And it kind of sucks because I'm a solo player. It's different like with this game because I do have friends that play on PC that I'm able to play with, but since I'm on PS4, a lot of my friends are on PC and I don't really have a lot of friends to play video games with. I'm completely okay with that. I enjoy being a solo player, but the experience on this game as a solo player really does suck. And let me explain to you why. So say in a game you land with your team, you're playing with a duo, and you and one of the other duo players dies. Well, obviously when the other guy comes to revive you, he's going to pick his duo all of the time. I mean, that's just a natural thing that you would expect to do. And the problem is that you end up waiting for a very long time. It's almost just pointless to even wait for a duo player to revive you because it's so expensive to revive players right now. And I think the one big change that they can make is to kind of have the price of reviving a teammate gradually go up and be cheaper in the beginning of the game. Because I think that's one of the reasons that a lot of people leave is after they just die in the gulag, they usually don't expect them to get revived because teammates either spend it on, you know, the care package drops or kill streaks. And it's really weird how no one really gives a shit if you die and they're like, all right, we're down a person, but who cares, man? Fuck him. That experience really does suck. And I think the way to fix that is to just make respawning, like the price for respawning teammates, a lot cheaper in the beginning of the game. I think it should only be like maybe like 1,000 or 2,000 to respawn in the beginning, just because most people are going to die in the beginning. And if you want this battle royale to be as intense as possible, and to be, you know, as many people alive on the map like throughout the game, I think they should definitely make it a little cheaper in the beginning to respawn teammates. And then once it gets towards the end of the game, obviously that's when it probably should be around 4,500 or maybe even more coins to respawn someone, because it's worth a lot more to have teammates towards the end of the game. But that's mainly my biggest concern. I honestly haven't really found anything else too wrong with this game. I think there's some little glitches here and there with the parachuting and just some of the aspects of the map, but that is 100% going to be fixed in the future. I also heard some people talking about how there are definitely going to be adding solos and duos very soon, and I think that'll basically solve all of the problems I just mentioned before of the solo experience. I mean, obviously, if you can play solos in-game, then you don't have to worry about teammates ever. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'm hoping that eventually does come out. And I just really want to quickly hear your guys' thoughts if you have played Warzone, or just after watching this video, if you haven't played Warzone, let me know what you guys think of this game, whether it's something that you're going to try. I believe this game is free for everyone. Despite if you don't have Modern Warfare, you can still play Warzone. I know on PC they use the Blizzard client. On Xbox, you might need Xbox Gold, and I think PS4, anybody can play it. So You might have to double check that. Don't take my word on it. I didn't do my research before. But yeah, just let me know down in the comments below what you guys think of this game, if you guys want to see me post more. I'm having a blast, and I probably will post more despite what people say. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video or found it useful. If you did, drop a like, subscribe to the channel. I'll see you guys next time, though. Have a great day. Peace out.